Remember this.
Australia's economic engine is roaring back to life.
Australia continues to lead the world out of the global COVID recession.
The Australian economy is rebounding strongly.
According to the latest national growth figures, that's true. But today's GDP results are already ancient history, not reflecting the current economic woes lockdowns are causing.
The digits and the decimals don't mean much to Australian families who already feel like their economy is in recession.
Today's GDP growth figure for the June quarter came in at 0.7%, taking the annual rate of growth to a record high of 9.6%.
Our economy remains resilient, that its fundamentals remain sound, that our economy remains strong.
But there's still a sting in the tail. These figures are old news. As of right now, lockdowns mean the economy is already going backwards again, which will be confirmed at the beginning of December, when this quarter's results get released.
Our economy has some very difficult days ahead.
The slowing and now shrinking economy is a direct consequence of the government's failures on vaccines and quarantine and economic support.
Today's national accounts only take in 1 week's worth of the Sydney lockdown, which started at the end of June, and none of the lockdowns Melbourne or Canberra currently faces.
If we don't stick to the national plan, businesses will close.
The September quarter will see the economy shrink.
A technical recession requires two negative quarters of economic growth. This one was positive, the next will be negative. And if lockdowns persist until Christmas, the last quarter just might be two, which would deliver a double-dip recession.
But we won't find that out until March, which might be during an election campaign. Peter Van Onselen for 10 News First.